India plans to invite Australia to join the annual Malabar Naval Exercise that has so far included just Japan and the US in a move that could risk China's ire. The decision to include Australia in the drills, the first time all members of the regional grouping known as the Quad will be engaged at a military level, comes as Beijing and New Delhi are caught up in their worst border tensions in 4 decades. The exercise will bring together the navies of India, Japan, Australia and the United States of America in the Bay of Bengal at the end of the year. New Delhi is expected to clear the way next week for a formal invitation to Australia following final government clearance and consultations with the US and Japan as said by the officials. To get in more in detail with this particular information and various other important inputs, let us begin with today's defense updates of 11th of July 2020. And as I always introduce to you before beginning about the defense updates, that SSB Crack Exams is India's largest, most preferred online defense exams preparation portal. We are one-stop solution for you if you are preparing for NDA, CDS, AFCAT, INET, Territorial Army and Indian Air Forces, Airmen Group X and Group Y. You can follow us on YouTube, Instagram, Twitter and Telegram, and you can even directly visit us through our website learn.ssbcrackexams.com. You can even download an app from Google Play Store where you can have each and every defense related information, examination related study material and all sorts of informative content in your hands. Beginning with the question of the day that I have posted on 10th of July 2020. And the question that I asked you guys was, what is UNDOF and why was it signed? In the other sense, what is UNDOF and why was it signed? As I appreciate you always that most of the people who have given the correct answer in the comment section, it is very good. Congratulations. The correct answer is United Nations Disengagement Observer Force is actually formed on 31st of May 1974 by the United Nations Security Council Resolution number 350. Understanding, this resolution was passed on the same day the agreement on disengagement was signed between Israeli and Syrian forces on the Golan Heights, finally establishing a ceasefire to end the 1973 Yom Kippur War or the Arab-Israeli War. Okay, the Israelis were supported by the United States of America, whereas the Syria was supported by the Egyptian and all sort of other forces and even the Russia. Okay, both of these were having a problematic issues and this also had a link up with the Syrian civil war too. So the Arab-Israeli war ended in the year of 1973, and when that day an agreement on disengagement was signed between both the Israeli and Syrian forces, it is on the same day the United Nations Disengagement Observer Force was formed on 31st of May. Okay, so the force has since performed its functions with full cooperation on both sides. The mandate of UNDOF has been reviewed and renewed every 6 months since 1974, most recently under 31st December 2019. Okay, United Nations Truce Supervision Organization and United Nations Disengagement Observer Force are both operating in the zone and they continue to supervise the ceasefire. Understanding? Now let us begin with first and foremost important defense update, and that is that our Defense Minister Shri Rajnath Singh ji holds a telephonic conversation with Defense Minister of Republic of Korea or South Korea. Rajnath Singh ji informed Mr. Jong Kyung-do. Jong Kyung-do is the Defense Minister of South Korea. Both of them have had telephonic conversation and our defense minister has reviewed about and he spoke about the international efforts against COVID-19 and even discussed the areas of mutual cooperation in the global fight against the pandemic, and they even shared the views on regional developments of shared security interests, and both of these were also being discussed by both of the important ministries. Going on with the next important defense information is that Boeing delivers 5 Apache helicopters to India by today, and all of these have been taken up and they were delivered at the Hindon Air Force Station in only one single consignment to the Indian Air Force, and this has been done at Indian Air Force. The United States, France and Russia have agreed to supply military systems within 3 months once an order is placed, says the government sources. To get in more in detail about this particular information and what all are the specialities of the Apache helicopters, you can even go through our blog and you can even download an app wherein which you can get a free PDF study material for this everyday current affairs and defense current affairs. So you can have a very detailed analysis of each and every day. Going on with the next important information is that in a clear message to China, India is to invite Australian Navy for a Malabar drill. This is what I was discussing with you in the introductory session. This exercise will bring together the navies of India, Japan, Australia and United States in the Bay of Bengal at the end of the year. Okay, India's inclusion of Australia this year follows a defense agreement and upgrading ties to a comprehensive strategic partnership. Okay, mutual logistics support agreement announced in May by both the Prime Ministers Narendra Modi and Australian Prime Minister Scott Morrison allows access to each other's bases and ports. Okay, going on with the next important defense update is that India expresses intent to carry out navigation activities in South China Sea, and this was being done by both of those, and both are Prime Minister Narendra Modi and the Philippine President. Both of them have had a telephonic conversation few days back, and both of them have decided to expand our both strategic partnership with the Philippines in the South China Sea region. And it was due to this particular telephonic conversation and the talks between both of the countries' important delegations that we have decided and we spoke out that we have to carry out the navigation activities in South China Sea. Even the Philippine Defense Minister Delfin Lorenzana, she even said that the navigation in South China Sea is open to all countries, since they didn't even stop the United States, the United Kingdom, England and Australian forces that are taking up the navigation activities all across the South China Sea. Going on with the next important defense information is that Russia is providing maintenance for India's aircraft carrier Vikramaditya despite the pandemic. And how is this being going on? Because there were a group of Russian technical specialists and they came to our country to assist us in providing maintenance for our aircraft carrier Vikramaditya, formerly known as Admiral Gorshkov. Admiral Gorshkov was that particular aircraft carrier of the Russia, and we took up this particular aircraft carrier, and upgradations have been done at the most important shipyard, that is the Sevmash shipyard in Russia. And we have done an intergovernmental agreement with Russia, and this has been signed in New Delhi in the year of 2004. And we took up the Gorshkov's hull completely for free, but we had a condition that the upgrade will be done at the Russian shipyard and outfitting will be done only with the Russian made aircrafts itself. Okay, going on with the next important defense information is that Maruti Suzuki delivers 718 units of Gypsies to Indian Army in June 2020. Powering the Gypsy is a BS4 compliant 1.3 liter petrol engine that puts up 80 horsepower of maximum power and 103 nautical miles of peak torque. Okay, the car comes with a four-wheel drive setup as standard and gets a low-range gearbox. Maruti Suzuki first launched Gypsy in the Indian market in December 1985, and the car went on to become a popular choice for the law enforcement in the country, and thanks to its performance, reliability and go-anywhere capability. Okay, going on with the next important defense information is that India looks at the next step after pullback by Chinese troops. Rajnath Singh is to meet with National Security Advisor Ajit Doval, the Chief of Defense Staff General Bipin Rawat and all other chief defense officials, which include the Army Chief General Manoj Mukund Narwane, the Navy Chief Admiral Karambir Singh and even the Air Force Chief Rakesh Kumar Singh Bhadauria. So all of these are going to discuss, sit together, and this is being done on Thursday, that Defense Minister Rajnath Singh will be chairing a meeting with all the important officials that I've cited here. And the sources say that a complete review of preparedness, situation on the ground, verification of the reports on pullback and all other future strategies are going to be discussed in the cards in the meeting. Going on with the next important defense information is that armed forces is to limit flying cheetah helicopters as COVID hit spares production at Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. This is being done that HAL has reduced its production of spares for the aging fleet of helicopters due to the COVID crisis, as it has been communicated to the forces that the shortage is expected to last around 3 months. Okay, Cheetah is powered by Artust 3B turboshaft engine and is suitable for commuting, observation, surveillance, logistic support, rescue operations and high altitude missions. Okay, going on with the next important defense information is that one Bihar unit is going to replace the 16 Bihar unit regiment at the Galwan Valley. The brave 16 Bihar regiment that lost its colonel on June 15 was scheduled to leave the Galwan area in April, but the movement was disrupted due to the restriction on movements imposed to curb the spread of COVID-19. And all of this 16 Bihar regiment brave soldiers will be shifted to a peaceful location, and all of them will be shifted to Hyderabad. And the main posts that were manned and guarded by these 16 Bihar regiment people will be replaced by one Bihar people. Going on with the next and final important defense information is that AM General receives $44 million for Humvee diesel engine. What is Humvee? Humvee means high mobility multi-purpose wheeled vehicle. Okay, the full form of Humvee could be a high mobility multi-purpose wheeled vehicle, and all of these vehicle diesel engines with containers for worth more than $44 million will be contracted, and this is being done between the United States Defense Logistics Agency and Land and Maritime and to the AM General. Okay, AM General developed, tested, launched what has now become the most iconic light tactical vehicle in the world, high mobility multi-purpose wheeled vehicle or Humvee. Okay, now we'll have a very quick review by discussing with most important questions that we have discussed for today. And the first and foremost question is, Minister of National Defense of Republic of Korea is, the Minister of National Defense for Republic of Korea is Jeong Kyung-do, also mentioned in the comment section. Who is Moon Jae-in, who is Chung Sik-kyun, and who is Hong Nam-ki? Next question is, the 5 Apache helicopters have been inducted in one consignment to the Indian Air Force at which Air Force station or which airbase? They have been delivered to the Hindon Air Base, which is the largest Air Force station in our country. Okay, going on, the next important question is, India plans to invite which country to join the annual Malabar Naval Exercise that has so far included just Japan and the US in a move that could risk China's air? So, including with our three countries, that is India, Japan and US, which is that other country which is going to be come up and which is going to join this particular Malabar Naval Exercise? And the answer for that is Australia. Okay, next question is, India received the Gorushkov's hull for free, but on condition of its upgrade at which shipyard and its outfitting with Russian made aircraft? And the answer for this is the Save Mash shipyard of Russia. Going on with the next important question is, HAL has reduced its production of spares for aging fleet of which helicopters due to COVID crisis? This is for the Cheetah helicopters. Okay, and the next question is, HAL has collaborated with France's Turbomeca to make a more powerful Shakti engine for the Cheetah in which of its variant for use in high altitudes? Now this is a very important question, and it's a GK question that I've thought to give it to you because we have discussed about the Cheetah helicopters. So Cheetah is going to be upgraded, and with it, with this particular Cheetah helicopter, we will include a Shakti engine. This Shakti engine is going to be manufactured by the France's Turbomeca industry. Okay, Turbomeca industry, we are collaborating, that HAL will be collaborating with Turbomeca to make a Shakti engine, so that this particular combination will be helpful for the high altitudes. Okay, so what is that important helicopter that will be helpful, and what is that variant known as? That variant is known as the Cheetal. Okay, and the correct answer for this is option A, Cheetal. Okay, next question is that the full form of WMCC of India-China Border Office. We have a important term that is being known as the WMCC, which is going to be discussed in whenever when you're talking about India-China Border Office, you have to speak about WMCC. And the full form of WMCC is the Working Mechanism for Consultation and Coordination. Please remember, this is a very important one. The answer for this one is the Working Mechanism for Consultation and Coordination. Whenever you are answering or whenever you are giving a lecture in the lecturate at SSBs regarding the India-China border issues and all of the important terminologies that are considered, please do mention about WMCC, that is the Working Mechanism of Consultation and Coordination. That will be very much helpful in boosting your points. Okay, now we have the question of the day, and the question of the day for today is, INS Vikrant, the new aircraft carrier of Indian Navy that is going to be commissioned in 2022, can carry how many aircrafts? I repeat, INS Vikrant, the new aircraft carrier of Indian Navy that is going to be commissioned in 2022, can carry how many aircrafts? Okay, the answer for this and the explanation for it, I will be giving you in the next session. Until then, stay tuned to SSB Crack Exams. Subscribe to this particular channel. Download an app from Google Play Store. And last but not the least, stay home, stay safe, and Jai Hind.